Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. This video is part of operating systems video course. Today's topic is storage structure. Topics covered in this video are what is memory, different forms of memory, requirement for the secondary storage, storage hierarchy, and the performance metrics of storage. All forms of memory provide an array of bytes. Each byte has its own address. Interaction to memory is achieved through a sequence of load or store instructions. The load instruction moves a byte or word from main memory to an internal register within the CPU. We have main memory and a register, and a byte which is stored in main memory is moving towards the register. This instruction is called load instruction. The store instruction moves the content of register to the main memory. We have main memory and a register, and a byte which is stored in register is moving towards main memory. This instruction is called store instruction. The CPU can load instructions only from main memory, so any programs to be run must be stored there. Different forms of memory. There are several forms of memory: RAM, random access memory, ROM, read-only memory, and EEPROM, electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. General purpose computers run most of their programs from rewritable memory called main memory or RAM. ROM cannot be changed, only static programs or bootstrap programs are stored there. Unlike ROM, EEPROM can be changed, but it cannot be changed so frequently, so thus it contains static programs. For example, smartphones have EEPROM to store their factory installed programs. For faster execution of any programs, we need to store those programs and data in main memory permanently. This arrangement is usually not possible because of the following two reasons. The main memory is usually too small to store all needed programs and data permanently. Main memory is a volatile storage device that loses its content when the power is turned off. This most computer system provides secondary storage as an extension of main memory, and the most common secondary storage used is magnetic disk, which provides storage for both programs and data. The storage device hierarchy. The storage structure consisting of registers, main memory, and magnetic disks is only one of many possible storage systems. Others include cache memory, CD-ROM, magnetic tapes, and so on. The main differences among the various storage systems lie in speed, cost, size, and volatility. Storage device hierarchy. The wide variety of storage systems can be organized in a hierarchy according to speed and cost. The higher levels are expensive, but they are fast. As we move down to the hierarchy, the cost per bit generally decreases, whereas the access time generally increases. Volatile storage loses its content when the power to the device is removed. The storage system above the solid state disk are volatile. As you can see in the image, registers, cache, and main memory are volatile, whereas those including the SSD and below are non-volatile. SSD, magnetic tape, magnetic disk, and optical disk are non-volatile storage. In the absence of expensive battery and generator backup system, data must be returned to the non-volatile storage for safekeeping. Performance metrics of storage. As you can see in the image, registers, cache, main memory, SSD, and magnetic disk are categorized by typical size, their implementation technology, access time, bandwidth, managed by, and the backed by. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, please do comment. Do not forget to subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon for the regular updates. Thank you.